After 60 years, scientists still haven't been able to explain why Earth pulses every 26 seconds. This is a puzzle with a cyclically predictable mysterious motion wrapped around it. It might be a harmonic phenomenon, a regular seismic chirp brought on by the energy of the sun, or a beacon luring researchers to its location to start a treasure hunt. Before 9:30 UTC on November 11th, a strange rumbling shook the entire planet. The seismic waves started around 15 miles off the coast of Mayotte, a French island located midway between Africa and the northernmost tip of Madagascar. The waves buzzed across Africa, vibrating sensors in Zambia, Kenya, and Ethiopia. They traveled through immense oceans, humming past Chile, New Zealand, Canada, and even Hawaii, which was almost 11,000 miles away. These waves didn't just pass quickly. They continued touring for over 20 minutes. And yet, appears that no one else sensed them. The strange signal was only picked up by one person on the real-time seismogram screens at the US Geological Survey. The odd zigzags were seen by a fan of earthquakes who goes by the Twitter handle at @MaterikaPax. As academics from all around the world worked to determine the source of the waves, that low action caused another form of ripple, a meteor strike, perhaps a volcano eruption beneath the sea, a long extinct marine monster emerging from the depths. According to Goran Ekstrom, a seismologist at Columbia University who specializes in rare earthquakes, "I don't think I've seen anything like it. It doesn't mean that, in the end, the cause of them is that exotic," he clarifies. "But the waves have a lot of strange features, from their unusually uniform, low-frequency ring to their global distribution, and the geologic mystery is still being investigated by scientists. Why are low-frequency waves such an odd phenomenon? Normal earthquakes release the built-up tensions in the Earth's crust with a shock in a matter of seconds." According to Stephen Hicks, a seismologist at the University of Southampton, this causes a wave train, a sequence of waves to emanate from the location of the rupture. Primary waves, or P-minus waves, are compression waves that move in bunches and are the fastest moving signals. They resemble what happens to an extended slinky when it is quickly pressed at one end. The subsequent waves are the secondary waves, or S-minus waves, which move more obliquely. According to Hicks, a sort of ping rather than a rumbling can be heard in both of these alleged body waves at quite high frequencies. Slow, long-period surface waves, which resemble the weird signals that emanated from Mayat, finally start to chug along near the end of the coast. According to Hicks, during strong earthquakes, these surface waves can round the globe several times, ringing Earth like a bell. The recent slow waves, though, did not originate from a significant earthquake. The fact that Mayat's mystery waves are monochromatic just makes things weirder. Unlike the waves that are often sent out by earthquakes, which have a variety of frequencies, Mayat's signal was a crisp zigzag that was dominated by one kind of wave and repeated steadily for 17 seconds. Anthony Lomax, a self-employed seismology specialist, claims that it feels like you have colored glasses on and they're just seeing red or something. Volcanic origins of Mayat. According to the scientific investigation carried out thus far, the tremors appear to be connected to a seismic swarm that has affected Mayat since last May. In that time, the small nation has been shaken by hundreds of earthquakes, the most of which originated around 31 miles offshore, to the east of the occasional ringing. The majority of these were small tremors, but the biggest one, strongest in the island's recorded history, was measured at magnitude 5.8 on May 2015. However, the frequency of these tremors has decreased recently, and none of the area's usual quakes were audible on November 11 when the mystery waves first appeared. A new center of volcanic activity may be emerging off the coast, according to the French Geological Survey BRGM, which is keeping a close eye on the recent tremors. Although Mayat was created by volcanism, its geological monsters haven't erupted in well over 4,000 years. Instead, According to BRGM study, this new activity might be indicative of magmatic action kilometers from the coast, thousands of feet beneath the surface of the ocean. Although this is wonderful news for the islanders, it is frustrating for geologists because there hasn't been a lot of in-depth research done in this region. According to Nicholas Stalfer, head of BRGM's Seismic and Volcanic Risk Unit, the location of the swarm is on the edge of the geological maps we have. There are many things that remain unknown. And as for the mysterious wave that occurred on November 11th, he notes that it's something quite new in the signals on our stations. According to information from the National Institute of Geographic and Forest Information, GPS sensors on the island have been monitoring its movement since mid-July. It has been sliding more than 2.4 inches to the east and 1.2 inches to the south. These data allowed Pierre Briol of the École Normale Supérieure in Paris to determine that a magma mass roughly a third of a cubic mile in size is pushing through the Earth's crust close to Mayat. According to Lomax, who discovered the faint pings by filtering out the low-frequency signals, the initial period of rumbling was also overprinted with what appeared to be the P- and S- waves of minor earthquakes. Such pings are frequently attributed to magma that is squirting through the crust and breaking rock as it moves. Helen Robinson, a University of Glasgow PhD student in applied volcanology, notes that even those indications were a little odd. She remarks, "They are too nice. They are too perfect to be nature." But she swiftly adds that an industrial source is improbable because neither drilling or wind farms are being built in the deep waters off Mayotte's coastline. According to Ekstrom, a kind of earthquake, roughly the size of a magnitude 5 temblor, actually started the events on the morning of November 11th. He asserts that it was a slow earthquake, which is why it mainly went ignored, because they result from a slow release of tension that might last for minutes, hours, or even days. These earthquakes are quieter than their faster cousins. Ekstrom claims that although the same deformation occurs, it does not occur suddenly. Volcanic activity is frequently linked to these weak quakes. A comparable progressive earthquake and low-frequency waves were connected to the collapse of a magma chamber at the Mount Nyiragongo volcano in the Democratic Republic of the Congo. During the most recent eruption of Kilauea in Hawaii, which produced roughly 60 of these events between May and the end of July and caused seismic waves to travel across the globe, slow earthquakes were also a startlingly common occurrence. What then is the real reason for the Mayotte's ultra-slow vibrations? These low rumblings might be the result of a subsurface explosion. However, there is no proof of it yet. The majority of present-day theories center on resonance in a magma chamber that is caused by a subsurface movement toward chamber collapse. According to Ekstrom, the resonance itself can take the form of any kind of rhythmic motion, such as the sloshing of molten rock or a pressure wave that is propagating across the magma body. Seismic wave analysis complex features may hold information about the size and shape of the molten stuff lying underneath. Jean-Paul Ampuero, a seismologist at the University Côte d'Azur in France, describes it as like a musical instrument. The notes of a musical instrument, whether they are grave or extremely pitchy, depend on the size of the instrument. According to Lomax, the strange homogeneity of the signal may be partly caused by the nearby rocks and sediments. Perhaps the surrounding geology is filtering the noises and only allowing this one wave period, lasting 17 seconds, to escape. Robinson agreed with this assertion and points out the region's extraordinarily intricate geology, a region crisscrossed by ancient faults, including fracture zones from the southern supercontinent Gondwana's final split, is where Mayotte is located. Likewise, the crust beneath is in a state of transition, alternating between the thick continental crusts and the thinner oceanic crusts. Robinson speculates that the simplicity of the escaping waves may be caused by this complexity. However, for the time being, it is difficult to say more about the wavy forms due to the lack of data. In contrast to a magma chamber draining or collapsing, Hicks' preliminary simulations suggested that the waves were caused by subsurface expansion, with some extra information. However, the model changed and began to predict chamber deflation. According to Robinson, it might even be a combination of the two. Some collapse mechanisms. You can get inflation and deflation occurring at the same time, she explains. Alternating up and down like the burning lungs of Earth is another option sometimes. Robinson asserts that it is really difficult to say what the causes, whether anyone's theories are accurate, or even whether what I'm saying has any relevance to the outcome of what's happening. To gather more specific information about the area and look into the possibilities of an underwater eruption, BRGM aims to conduct surveys of the ocean's bottom. With the information at hand, seismic sleuthing continues in the interim. Whether the cause is common or unusual is still up in the air, according to Lomax. But the science and the fun is in the hunt. He claims that, depending on the field and the period of time, 99.9% of the time, it's ordinary, or noise, or a mistake, and 0.1%, it's something. However, it is simply how things are. It should proceed in that manner. That is a development in science. With that being said, do you think the Earth really has a pulse? Please subscribe to Weather Collapse if you want to know more and be updated on the latest news about natural calamities or disasters happening all over the world. And don't forget to like today's video. We'll see you in the next video. Thanks for watching.